One of my favorite things about Studio Ghibli movies is the water. Be it a lake, the sea, a little stream of water, or just a bathtub, they really make the entire environment shine and feel alive. This scene in particular from Totoro is one of my favorites. It's just so perfect, because the water's physics behave exactly in the way you would expect, making the entire shot feel incredibly realistic. That's also the case when there are clearly some fantasy elements on the screen. Personally, I've never seen a train running on water and splashing a spirit that's next to the tracks. But goddammit, if such a thing could ever happen, then this is exactly what it would look like. As I have mentioned before in another episode, it's exactly this, that exquisite mixture of fantasy and realism that makes these movies so special to me. Welcome once again. This is the fourth entry in the devlog of the Nameless Ghibli Project, and in today's episode, we'll be talking about the river in the scene. Having a natural outdoor scene like this one without water would be a little bit like eating pizza without cheese. It's just no good. The river, or stream if you will, gives the environment a nice color contrast, and it just makes the whole thing feel fresh and alive. Personally, I think it really came out great, although it's still missing the kind of realistic quality that can be seen in Studio Ghibli movies. I definitely want to polish it up later in development, and find out if I can give it the realism by adding a couple of things like transparency, refractions, reflections, and some particles here and there. For now though, this is gonna be enough. Aside from taking references from movies, I also looked up what other people had done in Unity and Blender. And, as it turns out, there's a lot of people making great 3D water out there. And I mean a lot. Just look at this! I mean, the quality is amazing! Some of them are for games, other are environment pieces, and some other are just tutorials for other people to learn about this. But they are all amazing projects. In my specific case, I wouldn't have been able to make my water without the help of Nick Carver's amazing waterfall and Flaroon's super nice foam effect. Also, a huge shoutout to Simon Trümpler, who worked as a VFX artist on Rime and shared all of his secrets about those beautiful stylized waterfalls and lots of other stylized effects with the community. All the links will be down in the description in case you want to know more about them. Okay, enough of that now. Let's take a look at the specific effects we're gonna be talking about. The three steps to making this nice little stream come to life are the texture, which will define the general aesthetic of the water, a bit of vertical movement, aka small waves, and to finish it off, the foam that can be seen on the borders of the stream. All of them are being controlled with a custom shader which I made using Unity's shader graph. Now, let's finally dive into it. In the beginning, I had something like this. Just a simple plane that was placed in the position where I wanted to have my stream. Then, I started creating the effects in shader graph. In the main graph, you can see we've got the three components we mentioned before: the texture, the waves, and the foam. Let's start with the texture. This sample texture 2D node will define the surface texture of the plane, and it's gonna use whatever file we feed it from here. Then, the UVs will be controlled by this tiling and offset node, which in turn is controlled by time multiplied by speed, making the texture move and giving the impression that the water is flowing. That speed property will be exposed in the inspector, so we can later make adjustments from there. Then, to actually make the texture, I went to Affinity Designer and started drawing. Here, I pretty much made a one-to-one copy of Carver's texture from the waterfall video I showed you earlier. After exporting the image as a PNG file, I set it as the texture of this node, completing this subshader's functionality. If we go back to the scene, we can see that it's already looking much better and it actually resembles a river instead of just a planar surface. As mentioned before, the speed can be adjusted from the inspector tab. And for some reason, not only the horizontal speed, but also the vertical one. Not sure why I did this, but Yeah, there it is. Additionally, I also put an alpha slider. I want to add reflections and light refraction effects in the future, for which transparency is kind of a must. I hope this might prove useful then. Let's move on. Unlike the texture, the waves are made entirely in the shader graph, without the need of additional textures or any other files. Here, we're basically creating a vector 2 with the length and the width of the river's plane, which along with a speed property will be passed on to a gradient. Here, we're also creating the variables that define the scale and the height of the waves. This is all being passed on to a vector 3's Y scale, aka its height. The length and width of this vector 3 is coming from these nodes, which are simply the plane's length and width again. That way, essentially, we created a vector 3 with the plane's length, with the plane's width, but with a height that is being determined by the noise. Finally, this vector 3 will be set as the position and scale of our plane. Back in the scene, we've got something like this. Now our plane is not static anymore. By changing these values over here, we can adjust the scale of the wave's noise, the height of the waves, and also their speed. Let's put it to something nice like this. The last step to this water is the foam effect. It's also the most complex of them all. To be completely honest, I don't even remember exactly how all of it works.
What?
Yeah, don't look at me like that. I made it a long while ago, and actually I just copied it from different sources. Instead of embarrassing myself in any further attempt to explain it, I'll just point you to Flaroon's video. If you're interested in the foam, just go watch that video after this one. What I do know though, is how to use it. From the material, I can adjust the color, the speed, the depth, and the noise scale of the foam. Tuning it like this, we can get a very nice result. This final touch really makes the river come to life. So there you have it. This is the final result for our three-step water stream. It's definitely not the same as the magic you see in the Ghibli movies, but it also looks very good and gets the job done. It also gives a certain freshness to the whole scene, and it seems like a cool addition to what we've got so far. So yeah, I'm quite satisfied with the result. On another note, and as you might have noticed today, I'm still kind of figuring out the whole format of these devlog videos. I definitely don't want to make fully-fledged tutorials, but I also want to show some of the stuff that goes on under the hood. As you can see, striking that balance hasn't been easy for me. So yeah. Let me know down in the comments if it's getting too technical or too simple and what you prefer. I'd also love to hear your thoughts on the game, of course. And while you're down there, you can also give this video a like, you might also want to subscribe to the channel, and activate that little bell so you don't miss a single video. I'm gonna keep working on the project and sharing the process here on YouTube, so there's definitely gonna be more content coming. In the next episode, I will show you how I made this tree. It's, in my opinion, the ugliest asset I've made so far, but it's also the first one I made, and the one that actually inspired this whole project. That's gonna be all for today. I hope you enjoyed this video as much as I enjoyed making it. As always, thanks a lot for watching, have an amazing day, and I'll see you in the next episode. Bye-bye!